Today we're looking at commissioning our polymer manifold. We're actually in a property today which an overlay plus system has gone into. As you can see, we've used the polymer manifold, it's piped back to the boiler, set up as an S plan, and we're looking to fill the system first of all, circuit by circuit, bleeding all the air out, and then we're going to look at doing a heat commission after that as well. First things first, before we start filling the system, we need to ensure that these isolation valves are turned off before we start the filling process, and that protects the pump more than anything. So now what we're going to do, we've connected a hose pipe in onto the flow from the tap. As you can see, it's just a standard hose connector. Same from the drain off on the return, and that's running outside into a drain. Now what you'll notice is, when you couple a hose pipe onto here, the valve itself comes with a nut on. So before you connect your hose pipe on, just remove that cap, and then what we need to do is actually turn the valve itself to allow water to flow through it. If you don't do that, you won't get a water flow through the actual system itself. So what we've actually done is we'll take these clips off, anti-tamper clips. We've shut all the circuits off on the right hand side, including the top, and we've actually opened up our first one, both bottom and top, by removing the orange, could be a blue cap. We've now turned the water on. So essentially what's happening at the moment is the water supply is coming in through the flow of the manifold, down our first circuit, flowing through the circuit, back up through the return and out into the drain. What we're actually looking for is a constant jet of water. For a few minutes it might splutter, start, stop. Once we've got a constant jet of water and we're happy, leave it another minute or so, that means then that it's fully bled of air. We can then move on to the next circuit. So now what we're looking to do, now we know that circuit's filled, and bled of air entirely, we're going to leave the water supply on, shut our first circuit off, and what you'll notice is we're actually working from left to right because we're filling from the left hand side. If the orientation of the manifold is the other way around, we'll be doing it right to left. So we're shutting off that circuit both top and bottom, and then all we're going to do is open up the next one. Flow meter and the cap at the top, you can hear that straight away, water's now flooding into that circuit. And it's the same again, and now we continue that process on all the way till we get to the last circuit. And what this process enables us to do is any air that's left, any air that might be in the manifold, will go out through the last circuit, and then we know the system's completely filled and bled. So now all the circuits are filled, what we're going to do is tighten these valves back up where the hose pipe's connected to, making sure that then nice and tight, and then we'll turn the water supply off and we're ready for our heat commission. So now we've actually come to perform the heat commission on the polymer manifold. We've placed the demand on the system, ensured the heat source is fired up, in this case it's a boiler, also made sure that the two pot zone valves opened and that our pump's fired. Isolation valves are open. We're going to set the first flow rate. We're going to refer to our installation data sheet from the design, and it says our first circuit is 1 litre per minute. So all I'm going to do is open this up until the red disc is in line with 1 litre per minute. That's the first flow rate set. The second one is 1.4 litres per minute. So I'm just going to open that up until we get to 1.4. We're now at. It's important to note here that once you've set the second flow rate, the first flow rate might have dropped ever so slightly. So if we need to tweak it, open a little bit more, that's what you need to do. And all we need to do now is continue that on, ensuring that once we've opened up the next flow rate, that the ones before are still set correctly. If you need to adjust them, adjust accordingly. Last thing to remember as well at this point, it's also important that we haven't got any of the caps on or any actuator heads while we're performing the heat commission. Now we've balanced all the flow rates accordingly, what we're going to do is refit the actuator heads and the system is ready to go. Lastly, another thing to remember once you've set all your flow rates is we can use this little red nut, turn it clockwise up to the position we set the valve at. That just stops someone adjusting it back downwards. And lastly, put the anti-tamper sleeve back on, and that prevents the flow rate being adjusted when you don't want it to be in the future. Another great tip for you when you're installing any underfloor heating system is you actually label the pipes or on the nuts, as you can see here, what circuit's actually going to wear. And the same on the actuator head, we'll show you in a moment. On the top of the actuator head, we've actually put LR for living room, kitch for kitchen, whatever you want to put, and also the actual corresponding zone where it's wired into. And this just prevents any messing about if you have to come and look at it in the future. You know exactly what circuit's run into which room, which actuator head is wired into where, and it just saves any confusion for anyone future commissioning.